had a wetsuit, a wardrobe malfunction. There we go, Bruce's. Taking care of it. This is how to get in and out of a wetsuit on the beach.
Still not convinced.
Yeah.
That looks like it goes on the back.
That's the front.
Is that your seal?
Yeah, I was trying to figure out if I had it on backwards.
He
yep,
did.
The hammerhead goes in the front.
Okay.
Tony has the same seal.
Okay, we cool. So I started looking at it and I was like,
you're doing it backwards.
But that's what he was just saying, that hammerhead goes in the front.
I found this buoy this morning.
The hammerhead's not on the front, Bruce.
Or no. Talk
no,
about
that's in the back. Swing the back.
Okay, so I did have it on back.
Damn! There's some food on there.
Those are alive.
They're little mussels.
Yeah.
We got the first wildlife in the video. The mussels on the buoy. How long have you lived here, Chris?
Almost 3 years. I got into spearfishing within the first month.
So what do we expect to see out here? A few
a lot
fish.
Of turtles, definitely.
A lot of turtles.
Maybe a few reef sharks. Kala, unicorn fish. Boohoo is the parrot fish.
Wow.
Moray eel, barracuda, definitely.
How deep is it out there?
It's going to be about 8 feet to the break. After the break, it'll drop off to 25, 30 feet.
Are you going out past the break?
Hell yeah.
That's where we've been canoeing. We've been
we've
been taking a kayak out past it.
Every time I go past that break, I see schools of barjacks, barracuda, nice jaws, big fish. Boohoos are like this big everywhere.
Damn.
That's what I'm looking
for. Damn. We've hooked into something like that already. Man, didn't get it to the boat.
Into an
Ulu. We might have.
The Alua on there too, there are. Right now is a good time of year because the Alama, the little fish, is swimming in.
The bait fish?
Yeah, and they follow them in. So,
that's a lot better.
Yeah.
Thank you. Appreciate that, Ren.
Yeah, man. We gotta look right for the movie.
That's right. Are you going out?
Yeah, I'm gonna get y'all, film y'all getting in the water and then I'll follow.
With as many people as they got, Bruce, still.
Keep
distance. Would you keep a good distance with 6 people? With this many people, we'll guarantee to see 0 sharks. And then, but we'll scare a lot of fish for now.
Yeah, you want to keep 100 yards between people?
Yep.
Okay. If I try to film something, it should be from a long way.
You can film underwater.
Yeah, I got a GoPro.
Nice.
Yeah, 2 batteries too. We want to fill it up. I got a YouTube channel that we have it up on tonight.
Need to get a GoPro mount for your spear gun.
Yeah, I know, right?
What's that? You were saying you shoot it straight out.
No.
What's the battery life on those things?
I think I can get a total of, with 2 batteries, should be able to get 45 minutes. The first time I took it out, I think I got an hour out of it. And I don't know what, but I've been charging it all night. It should give me an hour each battery, but nice. Could be as little as 30 minutes.
Right. Kelly and I usually do like 4 or 5 hours straight at a time.
On your GoPro?
No, in the water.
In the water, yeah.
I'm pretty conditioned.
He was saying you shoot this straight out.
What's that?
How you shoot this straight out. Not.
What is that?
This one's the run Randy bought.
Nice, I like this thing. It's a hard load. Did it come from these rubbers like that?
Yeah.
Ooh,
we
like
put it off Craigslist. Rubber's kind of old.
I have new rubbers. I have new everything in my car. New line, new rubbers, new crinks, and all that.
You think it needs them before we go?
Someone put this guy together. After today, I would think after another time in the water, but somebody did this gun himself.
So it's good.
Is that enough string for the velocity coming off that chef?
Well, they all have the same. Mine, if you notice, has a reel on it.
Yeah.
So it needs a big fish too, but yeah, because it's vented underwater, it's only
going
to fire so far, you know?
Yeah.
This isn't a heavy duty spear, though. This thing will knock the shit out of something. I was just trying to burn your rope together because it's got the plastic coating, so not. Start wriggling, this can come apart. They should have tied on suicide. I have sleeves and wraps, metal ones. I can rig if we have to get back. So. Okay. That would melt that a little bit.
Hey, we'll pay you. We'll pay you for the. For any parts, man. My shit inside your knapsack.
Before going back to the house, just in case, could you just bring me my wetsuit?
Bring you your what?
My wetsuit.
Okay, where is it?
Into my room. There's, you know, the big like wardrobe.
Yeah.
And there's just one shelf on the top, and it's on the right hand side.
Okay. Okay.
You're gonna find it because there's just like t-shirts and stuff and the wetsuit. So.
Right.
Nothing can go wrong.
Oh, this is gonna be so good, man.
Yeah, because I think I'm gonna be more into in the water than I think. So I might need it, you know, and that's pretty cool. Oh well.
Bruce, you got anything you want us to lock up? Be careful with that knife in the water too, the way it's not gonna handle like a dive knife. It might try to float on you.
I don't even know if I'll have anywhere to connect it to.
I remember your dive knife. It made it into the film. The Randall Crowe episodes.
Yeah, and then let Johnny borrow it and it was gone after that.
What did Johnny say today? Play a lot on...
Which way shall I go?
To snorkel? Before. No, I haven't. I would go between, you get out to that stuff, all the dark stuff where all the action is.
Yeah, I was thinking that I'm going to go through there.
I'll probably go with you the easiest way out because these guys are, I don't know. I should have bought my life vest because I could wear it and get on out there and not have to worry about it. Yeah.